University. We are resiliency. We are one team. We are champions. We are the Hurricane.
Your starting five for your Holland College Hurricanes. A third-year guard from Halifax, Nova Scotia, number 2, Jaden Norden. From Nassau, Bahamas, a third-year forward, number 8, Chicken Wiley. A fifth-year forward from Reading, Pennsylvania, USA, number 11, Trinity. Fourth-year forward from Glasgow, Nova Scotia, number 14, Chase Bowden. And from Halifax, Nova Scotia, third-year forward, number 15, Travis Adams. Head coach is Mr. Josh Winnie. Assistant coach is Ryan Laughlin and Dale McCosick. Today's officials from Nova Scotia, lead official Matt Boyle, Greg Southerwood from Quebec, and Ryan Bissonnette from Ontario. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd ask you to please now rise and remove your caps for the singing of our national anthem with a Holland College student, Miss Jamie Coates.
Welcome back, everybody, to Holland College. Final game of the evening. I'm losing my voice here. Alongside Stephen Campbell, Ryan McCachran is our sideline reporter, and we're in for a treat here. The host team, the Holland College Hurricanes, they'll take on the Sheridan Bruins. And this should be a good one.
Yeah, a couple of powerhouses going at it here in Charlottetown. Obviously, Holland has the home court advantage, and it's a full house here for this game. Big St. Patrick's Day game with the right to advance to the gold medal game tomorrow against Montmorency, who we just saw win their own semi over VIU. And these two teams, a little bit different so far in this season. Well, for one, Sheridan Bruins are different from everybody else because they haven't lost yet, Peter. Since the first game of the campaign, they have yet to lose. They're 20-0, 21-0 even after yesterday. So unbelievable performance from them. And they are looking to advance to the CCAA final. And for Holland, they're coming off their fifth straight ACAA championship and their fifth straight appearance in this tournament. They played in this game a year ago in the semifinal, and they lost a heartbreaker to Humber College by 2 points. Came down to a last-second buzzer beater. And this is largely the same group coming back intact, so you know that they would love to fix that wrong and get back to the finals. So I think this is going to be a fantastic basketball game that we're going to witness right here in Prince Edward Island tonight.
So we're underway here. Final game of the evening on the line, a trip to the final. And right off the bat, a turnover by Cho Lee. And that's Norden. He runs out of track, but it goes off a Sheridan player. Inbounds, oh, that's a quick bucket right there. As that was Burdine. And this building is packed here. And it is Pro Holland College, as you would expect. Three ball launched there by Perriana, no good. And now Holland College will push the court. Burdine misses the three ball. In there, good hustle, the put back. So the bucket and the harm is Travis Adams will go to the line.
And these teams obviously coming off wins yesterday. Holland beat Sates 103-93 in an absolute thriller. The best game of the tournament by far. And a little bit more lopsided for the number one seeded Bruins as they dispatched Mount Allison easily 91-61.
So Holland College off to a great start. Adams converts on the three-point play and they have a 5-0 lead. Here's a long-range shot. That was Owosu, and now pushing it up is Norden. Stops, pops, can't drop it. Loose ball, oh yeah! That's Burdine, as he is hungry off the glass there. 7-0 lead for the Hurricanes. They kick it out, turnover. And back the other way is Norden. So a foul there on Paul Williams. So Sheridan, they want to talk things over as Nick Davis not happy with what he sees from his team right from the get-go. So he wants to nip that in the bud and try to get his team to settle down a bit.
Well, Holland is picking up right where they left off in yesterday's win over State, jumping out to an early 7-0 lead, and it didn't look like Sheridan was quite ready for that early offensive barrage as the Hurricanes already 3 of 5 from the floor. A couple of steals, a couple of rebounds, and assist as Burdine with the early 4 points. And the player to watch out for Sheridan is Owusu. That's number 33, Brian Owusu. As yesterday, the All-Canadian led his team with 26 points. He was shooting 11 of 22. Great shooting percentage there. And he's a player that can put the team on his back and can win a game single-handedly. So much like we saw in the last semifinal contest here, whenever Montmorency completely shut down Zade, that's what Holland has to do now to Owusu, because the secondary scoring around him is still pretty good, but he is the engine that makes this Sheridan team go.
He averaged 16.4 points per game during the regular season. Bowden inbounds it, and there's a nice touch there by Burdine. He's off to a good start here for the Hurricanes. Owusu, fadeaway, off the iron. And a reach-in foul called there against Hibbert. So this has not been a good start for Sheridan.
No, honestly, I don't think the Bruins could have had a worse start than what we've seen in the first minute, 45 seconds roughly, as it's been all Holland College early. And this is what they do. They jump out to these early leads, make other teams play from behind, and try to make them lose the game.
Coach Whitty has to be happy with what he's seen here from his team. Here's a jumper. And it comes to Perriana. And a turnover by Sheridan. And a nice little lay-in as that was Norton. And it's 11-0 start here for Holland College.
Already three turnovers for the Bruins. Very uncharacteristic play. Keep in mind, this is the number one seed in the tournament. They haven't lost a game all season long.
Norton. Berdine, and Berdine hitting a three, and then has a little stare down at the bench. I don't know if that's a good idea.
He's already got 11 points, 5 of 6 from the field. He's taken all but one shot for Holland. What a display from the veteran.
And then finally, as that Jolie hits the three. I don't think that's a good idea by Berdine to entice that Sheridan bench. Berdine tries the baseline shot. Oh, excuse me, that was Bowden who hit that one. So a 16-3 lead, a sizzling start here for Holland College. So Bowden takes the foul there, his first up.
We'll see if Sheridan can try to halt this early run as Holland has come out on fire, clearly energized. And this is where home court advantage is so big in these tournaments, as when you're the host, you get the automatic berth, obviously, but Holland is so comfortable playing right here on this court. And Sheridan very far from home.
That's Travis Adams who put up a bit of a prayer there, and it was answered. Perriana, his jumper, no good. And Holland College off to just such a great start here. The throw up, as that was Berdine with that alley-oop pass, and they couldn't convert. And that ball is in and out of the hands of Jolie, so Sheridan having all kinds of problems to start this game. 5:50 remaining in the first quarter. 18-3 in favor of the Hurricanes.
And keep in mind, you can reach out to us here on the broadcast. Send us a tweet. My Twitter handle is right there underneath the score at SCampbellTV1. Let us know where you're watching the game and who you're cheering for, and I will gladly give you a shout out on the air. Lots of great social media interaction so far in this tournament.
Bowden's banana putback, as that was Wiley right there to tap it in. 20-3. Here's Norton. Good ball movement. Norton wide open. Can't sink it, and now Williams gets the rebound. And here's Perriana, and he'll settle things down, try to get things going in the half court. And that's a foul against Holland College. So now it'll be Orosu. He'll inbounds the ball. Coming in is Joseph for Holland College. Adams will take a seat. Oh, nice shot there. Perriana sinks that one. So 20-6. Bowden's. Berdine misses it. And too hard on the putback. That's going to be Holland College ball.
Shots just not falling for the number one seeded Bruins early. Luckily for them, they've made 2 3-pointers. That's all of their 6 points there, which is 2 of 10 from the floor. With 4 turnovers, that's been the biggest problem.
Speaking of turnovers, Wiley loses the handle on that one. This crowd is alive here in Charlottetown. And they like what they see so far. 20-6 lead. Back the other way, Wiley. Oh, beautiful passing as he finds Joseph wide open. And Nick Davis taking a little bit of stroll. He's going to sit down. He's looking for some answers here from his Sheridan team. 21-0 going into this one on the season. Inside pass. Oh, great defense. As that's swatted away by Wiley. Off to the corner. No good. Loose ball. And Sheridan has possession. Inside now for Thompson. Then back out. As that goes to Campbell, and he sinks that. Wow, what a start here for Holland College.
Yeah, talk about a way to pump up your home crowd playing, hosting the tournament, and clearly, like I said, very comfortable in the confines of this building right here. Early 22 points for Holland.
Holland College, they were fourth in the Atlantic Conference. Won another title. And looking to punch their ticket to the final tomorrow. 23-8. And Norton makes both of his free throws. Okay, yeah, we'll come into the game now for Holland College. So into the game is Diol for Sheridan. And that's going to be a foul against Majok.
Smart decision by Campbell there. He's a slasher. He's one of those guards who's just going to get to the rim and make you make a stop on the way there. He's not afraid of taking some contact. Badly needed free throws. I know it sounds strange to say that so early in the game, but really any points right now for Sheridan just to try to cut into this lead, because they don't want Holland to get that lead too high heading into the second quarter.
Anything to get some confidence, so that's good there for Majok as he hits both of the free throws. Oh, nice lay in right there by Bailey. Got to get back on defense here, and they do. Perriana. Swing it over to the far side, and there's a three ball. And that's Diol knocking it in from downtown. Now, Nick Davis up off his seat, trying to urge his team to get some defense going here. Here's Burdine. His shot's no good. So 26-13, 2:35 remaining in the first quarter. Oh, three-pointer. As that Perriana sinks that one. So now you're starting to see the Sheridan team that we expected as they're coming alive a little bit.
Yeah, they clearly have captured the momentum now, and that start that Holland College had, that's not a pace that any team is really able to sustain throughout the game. You're going to have lulls here and there. Sheridan starting to bring it back a little bit.
That was Wiley with a nice turnaround baseline shot. Nice fake by Perriana. So 28-16, 1:45 remaining in the first quarter. Oh, nice inside pass. And right there, Bailey couldn't finish it off for the Hurricanes. Oh, good defensive play. That was Wiley. He got his hand in the face of Campbell, preventing him from getting that shot off. Wide open, here's Bailey. And he missed that one, nothing but air. So 112 remaining in this first quarter, 28-16 in favor of the Holland College Hurricanes.
Kind of surprising to see a miss from Holland at the rate that they've been going in the first quarter, as Burdine has paved the way. He's got 11 points, and almost all of those came in the first 3 minutes, I believe.
And the Hurricanes shooting the lights out here, 50%. Meanwhile, Sheridan shooting 31.3% from the field. Drive here and a spin. Well, they waved the bucket off, as that was Joseph that drove in there. So a foul against Holland College. So that was Bailey, and he'll sit for a little bit here. 40 seconds remaining in the first quarter. An explosive start here from the Holland College Hurricanes. Here's Williams, tries to back down his man, kicks it out. Cho Lee, his shot's no good. And Williams is gonna have to go off. He's skinned up his knee, and there's blood. So he's gonna have to come in the game and get that patched up. Blood on his knee.
Interesting to note as well, even though Holland is shooting 50% from the field, they're only shooting 12 from three, just 1 of 8 on trays. So even though they do have that big lead, Holland College is not a big three-point shooting team. They focus on their bigs and they try to get their damage done in the paint. We'll see if they can try to buck that trend in the second quarter, as there's a pull-up two.
Burdine, he is just simply on fire. He's not missing anything, it seems. Jolie. Diol, and Diol making a nice shot there. So that does it for the first quarter of this game. And Holland College and their fans very happy with what they saw after the first 10 minutes. They have a 30-18 lead. We're going to step out. We'll come back to Charlottetown with more right after this.
Oh, sorry.
Sorry.
Sorry. Sorry.
Sorry.
Sorry.
Sorry.
Sorry.
Sorry.
Sorry.
Oh! Sorry.
Sorry. What do you think of this one? Too small?
Yeah, I haven't worn that one in months.
And those pants look a little too short. Let's help other kids in our community and give these items to Big Brothers Big Sisters.
Big Brothers Big Sisters can turn your donations of clothing, shoes, and linen into funding for youth mentoring programs. To learn more about how Big Brothers Big Sisters is making a difference to kids in your community, visit bigbrothersbigsisters.ca.
Way to go, girls. See how easy it is to help someone else?
Welcome back, everybody, as you take a look at Paul Williams. He gets patched up, a little cut on his knee. Peter Ruckgazer, alongside Stephen Campbell and Ryan McCaffrey and the rest of the 5TV1 crew. What an explosive start by Holland College. They lead this one 30-18, but you get the sense here that Sheridan, they're getting things in order.
Well, like I said, Pete, the pace that Holland was on there in the first 3 or 4 minutes, that's not sustainable for the whole contest, as you're going to have your ups and downs. Sheridan started to bring it back a little bit, down by 12 now. I don't imagine this is going to be a runaway by Holland by any means. Sheridan hasn't lost a single game all year heading into this one, so it's going to be interesting to see how they react and if Holland can jump out to another red-hot start at the beginning of the quarter.
So Paul Williams has come back into the game. They patched up that knee. There's Adams. Oh, what a move by Adams. Slick move by the big man on the baseline. Then he trash talks. That's Rooney, I believe. Here's Diol. And Adams snatches that rebound. 15. He's a load. Turnover there by Kaya. Shot's no good. And now Kaya in the paint. Off the window and in. There's Puriana. He's going to launch one off the mark. Adams again. Kaya. He's tried to go off the window once again. No good. Puriana, he'll slow things down for Sheridan. Diol, low post. Gets it for Williams. Williams gets it stripped. That was Kaya taking it away from 42. Adams, double teamed. Adams, as he gets hacked, and that'll be Holland College ball. Adams is on a mission. Boy, I'm telling you. He's got some aggression going.
He's a fearless competitor. We've seen that through his years here at Holland. He isn't afraid of anybody. And one area, I'm just looking at the stats now, that really sticks out is rebounds. Is Holland, they specialize in their bigs. You look at players like Wiley, as well as Burdine, 6'6 each. Holland has 19 rebounds, Sheridan only with 7. And they normally win the rebounding margin, but it's been pretty evident so far.
And that pass turned over by Bowden. Here now, they kick it out. Diol trying for three, misses. Okay, let's send it over now to Ryan McCachran. Ryan.
The last Hurricanes huddle, and Coach told his guys he loved what he was seeing, to keep doing what they were doing. Coach said, keep it simple, guys. Just close out, box out, and this is ours. Let's see if the players listen to him, guys. Back up to you.
Thank you very much, Ryan. 34-18 lead for Holland College. And there's a second opportunity there for Owusu. Here's Joseph, his shot. Adams again. Adams has just been a simple beast on the glass here. Puriana on the drive, decides to hold up, looks for options. Cholee, that's a nothing but air. And Cholee a little frustrated with himself.
Flip it over to Twitter now. We got first tweet of the game from Veronica, and she says, hey, S. Campbell TV1, it's game time. Let's go Bruins. Abdul says they need the Pubtown combo. J. Dave, Tone, McAlpine one time. NSCC Finances, great start for the Hurricanes. Loving Air Travis Adams, sending maritime cheers from Halifax. Go Hurricanes. And Isabel says, shout out from Holland College residents across the street from Isabel and Haley. We're too lazy to walk over, so we're watching online. We appreciate you guys tuning in. And Crochet R Us says, big shout out to Kyle LaFave.
They're probably a lot more comfortable at home.
I think so, yeah. It's standing room only here at Holland. You can see on your screen, it's a packed house. Great to see Island basketball fans out in attendance.
And there's Diol as he lays that one in.
It's great to see everyone here. Isabel and Haley aren't here, but that's okay because they're tuning in online on 5TV1.
And that's Burdine. Burdine has just been solid here in this first half. Here's Williams, and he stays with the process and follows up and he gets the bucket. 24. 6:25 remaining in the second quarter. Adams gonna try his luck. Adams, he is simply doing everything. He's rebounding the ball, physical force, and then drilling that three-pointer.
Yeah, Travis Adams, bigger guy, 6'4", and he's 4-for-4 now, shooting with 10 points. He and Burdine are shouldering the load, a combined 25 between that duo. Very dynamic 1-2 punch for Holland.
Jolie. That was a difficult shot, and it's brought down there by Bowden. Adams. Norden, no room there. Here's Adams, he'll try another three ball. That hit the iron. They kick it out. And that shot is made there. Alosu. And that's a big shot for Sheridan College. And it's a 39-27 lead.
My sister is angry with me now because I didn't shout her out. I completely forgot. So shout out to Rebecca Gill for tweeting in twice. Hey, S. Campbell TV1. No shout out to your sister. There you go, Becca. Hope you're happy watching at home.
Ignoring your sister, are you?
That's not the first time. Yeah, it's been doing that for 27 years.
So 5:26 remaining in this half. It's a 39-27 lead for Holland College. And the atmosphere here, very, very electric. As you would imagine, a pro Holland College crowd. Having said that, a nice contingent of fans behind the Sheridan bench up from Toronto, trying to spur their team on.
Well, the way that Sheridan has brought it back here is with the three ball. They've already made 5 3-pointers compared to Holland's 2. Shooting 36% from downtown. Holland still out rebounding though, 22-12. And like I said, it's gonna be tough for Sheridan to win that battle when they're going up against bigs like Wiley, Burdine, and even Travis Adams, very good rebounder as well as shooter.
Burdine, he's 7-of-11 from the field. He's got 15 points, 3 boards and 1 dime. Holland College, they want to close out this first half solid. Try not to turn the ball over. Get some great defense. Mariana. And Nick Davis not happy with that call against Paul Williams. As the screen was set. And let's take a look at it here. I don't know, I'm in agreement with the Sheridan team.
Yeah, that's a tough one there.
Yeah.
I think I agree with you as well, Pete.
That's a tough call, and there you see Nick Davis. He's very frustrated after that call. Double team here. Comes to Burdine. Loose ball, Williams gets to it, he'll hang on. And now it's moved up the court here. Mariana for three. And wow, Sheridan, they're back in this one, just down by 9.
Once again, using that three-pointer to try to chip into this deficit. It's down to 9 now, and there's a turnover for Holland.
Oh, and now Sheridan teed up, and Coach Nick Davis is saying, I never said anything to somebody in the crowd, so they're gonna talk things over. Nick Davis never said a word.
This is the kind of stuff that it's so hard to police. Because if you get a technical foul, obviously Davis is saying that he didn't do anything,
oh,
and he is
my.
Not happy with the referees right now.
So a couple of bad calls A couple of bad calls here by the officials. Oh, that's really bad. That was a fan. Hey, listen, you pay your money, you should be able to get after the referees, and this referee made a major mistake thinking it was Nick Davis or somebody from the Sheridan bench, and it wasn't.
Yeah, Davis is in disbelief. He's still having some words with the referee now over there on the side. And
so Holland College gets the ball. Bowden. There's a fave with the shot, loose ball there. And now Sheridan has it, they'll push it up the court. Perriana, Diol. Perriana in there, and he gets knocked down. That'll be Sheridan ball. 4:09 remaining here in the second quarter. Diol, he gets pushed out. But they're going to say it's Holland College ball.
And just going back to that exchange there by Davis and the referees, Davis is still talking to the official there on the sideline. Obviously, you never want to get on the referee's bad side, but the way that it's gone now, it's not necessarily working in Sheridan's favor.
Mariana with the shot. And there's a foul against Holland College. That's LeFave with the foul. So Norden's going to check back in for LeFave. Get the ball out here for Williams. Owosu, he's going to drive. Owosu off the glass. Hurricanes by 8. Norden, he loses the handle, gets it back again, then loses it again. Perriana turns the corner, teardrop. And right there with a follow-up is Williams. Nick Davis is calling for his players to get hands up. Turnover. Owosu gets it over here and a foul on Nick Campbell. So wow, the momentum has really changed here. And Sheridan, they're right back in this thing.
I was going to say, yeah, look at the score now. Sheridan at the line. Going to try to make this a 4-point game. Holland College has let Sheridan right back in this one, and they are going to take a timeout now with 3 minutes left to go in the first half of play here in Charlottetown.
And you kind of knew that this Sheridan team would eventually settle down. There's too much talent, too much depth on that team. And still plenty of basketball left in this one.
Well, Holland College, we mentioned their struggles from beyond the arc. Just 2 of 14 now from three-point land. Still shooting 44% in general from the floor. But I think if you're Canes head coach Josh Whitty, you got to tell your guys to back off that shot here because it clearly isn't working in the first half. And that's not their strength anyway. That's not to say that they can't shoot three-pointers, but they're a much more effective team when they're working it down low in the post to players like Chicken Wiley, as well as Chase Bowden, Travis Adams. So let's see if they try to change up that strategy here, whereas Sheridan, it's the opposite story. They've already connected on 6 three-pointers, and the three-point shot is what's brought them back into this game.
Yeah, you got Perriana, he's 3 of 6 from three-point land. Owosu, 1 of 2 from three range, and Duell, 1 of 3. So now to the line is Nick Campbell.
interesting note here once again from our man at Holland, Jordy Carraher. And he said the last 2 years, a previously undefeated team lost in the semifinal. That was Holland in 15 and VIU last year. And he said in both cases, the team that beat them won gold. Humber in 15 and Nate last season. So that's not to say that that's going to happen again, but interesting to point out. And shout out to Jordy for the little tidbit.
So Holland College by four, 2:53 remaining in the second. Here's Adams. Shot's no good. That was Majok. He stays with it, kicks it out. Adams shaking and baking. He gets fouled. Boy, this is the first time I've seen Travis Adams play, and he is a ball of energy. A big man, and he doesn't move like a big man, that's for sure.
He's one of those guys that you want to have on your team because he's not afraid to go at other defenders, and he's going to go to work for you every single night. Real glue guy for this Canes club.
He's gotten into a couple of battles with big Paul Williams, and Adams right there with the steal, but they're going to call a reach-in foul against the Canes. So that's Adams, his first of the contest. Okay, let's check in now with Ryan McCracken. Ryan?
Last time out, and the coach told his guys to calm down and play defense, saying, D it up. Here we go. We've got to want it more than they do. Let's see if his players can do it for him, guys. Back up to you.
Thank you very much, Ryan. So now, lead has been shaved down to 2 points. Norton for Dine, knocking down three.
And sometimes for a defense, there's nothing you can do if a guy is shooting the ball as well as Berdine is doing now. There was two defenders right in his face, and he didn't even flinch, stepped up and knocked down that tray.
Baseline shot, no good. Back the other way. This is Joseph. He'll acquiesce there to Norton, and then a turnover. Oh, that's a heavy foul. As that was Majok. Man. Let's take a look at it right here. Wow, Majak, he came in with some ill intention there. And now heading to the line once again will be Nick Campbell.
The free throw is starting to add up as Holland is simply letting Sheridan make this game extra close. Now they've been in the bonus for the last 2-3 minutes, and Sheridan has been getting back to the line, as they are now 7-for-7 from the stripe after that shot there from Campbell, and he's gonna try to make it a perfect 8.
Campbell, during the regular season, he averaged 10 points, 3.9 boards for Sheridan. And there's a three-point play there by Kayaya. So that increases the lead to 6. No good. And that's Adams, as he knocks down Williams. Williams heads to the line. And I think they want to get Adams out of there. Adams is not aware that the foul was called against him. And probably a good thing to get Adams out of there with 1:26 remaining. misses the first of two. Wow, this crowd is loud here at Holland College. Verdine loses it right there to follow up, though, is Bailey. Eight on the shot clock. Inside, and they're going to call a travel against the Hurricanes. Bruins by six. Williams. Swing it around. It comes back to Perriana. Owusu. There's a long shot there by Choli. He's had some problems from distance. 43 seconds remaining in this first half. Owusu. Pinpoint pass inside to Campbell. Campbell. Too strong. Campbell again. The shot clock ran out. Shot clock violation against Sheridan.
Holland defense stepping up now late in the second quarter, forcing the turnover there. That's the ninth for the Bruins.
Shot's no good. Seconds left now. As Perriano just slow it down. Waiting for that last shot of the first half. Perriano, three-pointer. He gets knocked down.
Foul number six, Abel Joseph, his second. On the line, shooting.
So that'll be Perriano. He's going to shoot three as he was knocked down in the motion of shooting. So this ending is shaping up pretty good here for Sheridan.
Yeah, I think the Hurricanes are ready for halftime here. It seemed that way for the last couple minutes. Maybe fatigue starting to set in, getting a little bit sloppy, and they're simply sending the Bruins to the line far too much, as that's the ninth free throw made now in the game for the Bruins via Perriana. And remember, we mentioned that red hot start for the Hurricanes. They were up huge in the first 4 or 5 minutes, but then since then, Bruins showed that they weren't going to let that one get away. They're the undefeated team and the number one seed for a reason.
And a prayer shot there that misses. So Sheridan had some difficulties in the early going, just could not weather the storm from Holland College. They got off to a great start. And the Sheridan Bruins, they have scraped and clawed. They've got their game back. And now they are trailing by just 3 points here at the half. And very solid game here between these two teams.
And we knew it was going to be. Holland came in red hot after knocking off State yesterday. Sheridan, we know about their track record. Number one team in the country. They've been ranked number one in the CCAA since mid-January, I believe. So we knew that this was going to be a clash of the Titans, and it hasn't disappointed so far. Looking forward to a very exciting second half here in the last game of the day at Holland.
So the score, 46-43 in favor of Holland College. Our Brian McCachran waiting to get a chance to talk to head coach Josh Witte. Okay, let's send it down to Ryan. He's with Coach Witte. Ryan?
Coach, how'd you feel about your team's first half of play?
Well, I felt pretty good about the first quarter. I'm not real pleased with the second quarter. I thought the foul count got a little outrageous in the second quarter, to be honest.
Yeah,
12-7. I'd like to see us taking better care of the basketball and maybe knocking down a couple of those threes.
What are you going to tell your guys in the locker room so they're ready to come out for the next half?
Well, we talked about winning all four quarters today. So we won a half. We didn't win the second quarter. We got to win two quarters of basketball here. Treat every possession like a 0-0. And I think that'll get the job done.
Great. Thanks, Coach. Coach Withy, everybody. Back up to you guys.
Thank you very much, Ryan. So we're at the break. It's 46-43. Holland College, they lead Sheridan. We're going to take a break on the other side, our halftime show. You're watching Canadian College Basketball right here on 5TV1.
Wouldn't it be nice to have a big brother?
So what you want to do this weekend?
I want to go to the Canada Game Center. I want to go swimming on the big yellow slide, which goes outside.
Yeah, that'll be fun. Yeah. Definitely do that for sure.
Yeah.
Probably go bowling too.
Yeah.
Kids with mentors grow up to be more successful adults. Supporting Big Brothers Big Sisters is a great way to have a positive impact on your community. To volunteer or make a donation, go to bigbrothersbigsisters.ca.
Being part of an Easter Seals camp has really shaped who I am today. My dream is to see every kid in Canada living with a disability go to an Easter Seals camp so they can experience what I have experienced. See ability in disability. See the difference? Be the difference.
Text Easter to 45678. Make your $10 donation today.
Is that 5TV?
Oh, you know it, man.
With ultra-stunning 4K picture quality.
I love using Restart.
I use that all the time.
We love having Crave TV and Netflix right on it.
And having all my TVs set up wirelessly, it's amazing.
Can you imagine some people still don't have 5TV?
I don't have it. Because I was living abroad.
With so many reasons to love 5TV, it's time to make the switch to the best TV service.
ladies and gentlemen, give it up for the Holland Hurricanes dance team.
I'm gonna go.
Welcome back, everybody. 46-43, Holland College leading Sheridan. Let's send it down now to Ryan McCaffrey. He's with Sheridan head coach Nick Davis. Ryan?
Coach, how'd you feel about your team's first half of play down here?
Well, I mean, didn't play very well at the beginning of the game, but I thought we did a lot better in the second quarter and got ourselves back into the game.
What did you tell the guys in the locker room so they're ready to come out here in the second half?
Well, I mean, all we can say is that, you know, we got some tough calls, and we got to weather the storm. We got to kind of take the crowd out of it a little bit, ignore the crowd. The crowd's been fantastic for Holland, and we got to just kind of get the referees out of our heads, and we'll be okay. Need to rebound. We've done a really good job in the second quarter. Rebound, need to continue to do that, and we'll be okay.
Great. Thanks, Coach.
Thanks.
All right, guys, back up to you.
Thank you very much, Ryan. As Nick Davis, I know Nick Davis a little bit from my days in Toronto. He works for CBC, and he's been a longtime coach of this Sheridan team. Had a chance to talk to him in the media room, so he's done a great job with the Sheridan program. And they're down by 3 points, and Holland College looking to stay steady here after that great start.
Yeah, that was about as good as you can start a game for the Holland Hurricanes. Came out absolutely on fire. We're shooting the lights out. Tailed off a little bit there, and Sheridan came back into the game. One pattern that we saw heading into the half was Sheridan continually got to the line. They realized that Holland was getting a little bit weaker on defense in the paint, and they were exposing them there. And both teams, I mean, Holland, they started to turn it on a little bit from downtown. They hit 3 three-pointers to end that second quarter within the last 5 minutes or so. They're still only shooting 23% from beyond the arc. But both teams, pretty similar stats all across the board. Nothing really sticks out here, to be honest with you. But one guy that really waiting to get going is Owusu for Sheridan. He is their leader, and he's just 3 for 8. And he has 7 points, but credit the Holland defense for shutting him down. And for the Hurricanes, that duo of Burdine and Adams combining for 28 of Holland's 46 points. So that tells you the story right there. As how about that performance from Burdine, opening things up, hitting a couple of threes, and he's 8 of 14 from the field. And he's been their real anchor so far.
So we're about ready to get going. Both teams getting some final instructions here. And we'll see what kind of start Holland College has here in this third quarter.
Well, we have some time before then. Let's check out a couple more tweets. We got one from Veronica who says, "My boys, we'll get it back. Hashtag let's go Bruins." Joe says, "The Sheridan comeback is about to be real." Isabel, who's watching from Holland, would like us to know that she made some muffins. As
watching from where?
Holland resident. She's that tweeted that said that she and her friend were just too lazy to come over. So shout out to Isabel. Brianna Wilson says, "Let's go Bruins, number 42. That's Paul Williams. Camilla says, "Let's go Bruins, watching from Brampton with my family." And hashtag all day says, "Hurricanes do run out." So thank you for reaching out, everyone. Still lots of time to get those tweets in at SCampbellTV1.
So we're underway, third quarter action. And that was Hibbert. Try to convert the three-point play. And he can't get it to go, but back the other way, Holland College. There's Adams. All kinds of blue sweaters around him. Fights for that ball. And it's going to be Holland College ball, 14 on the shot clock. Bowden will inbounds it. Quick shot right here. That's off the mark, way off the mark. And now back the other way is Perriana. Wilson. Williams Jolie. Williams gets the rebound, and they're going to call Bowden with the foul.
And even though that shot didn't go down there for Jolie, that's the right play, and Sheridan's been running that to perfection so far, working it around, creating that high percentage shot from three. They've already knocked down seven of those, so look for them to continue that strategy going forward.
Owusu will inbound the ball for the Bruins. Gets it here for Perriana. And they're going to call Norden with the foul as he had the clutch on Perriana. ...46-45, Sheridan have clawed back into this one. Here's Perriana, little teardrop. Williams can't handle it. And they're gonna give it to Sheridan. Owusu will inbounds it. Plenty of time on the shot clock. Jolie. Owusu inside, and again it'll be Sheridan ball. Just six now on the shot clock. Catch and shoot, that hit the rim. And now Adams will come up gingerly here. Norden, gonna drive, Norden off the window. Nice play there by Norden.
And Pete, if there's one area where the Hurricanes have been struggling in, it's getting into foul trouble. You can see they already have three team fouls, and we're only a minute and a half into the third quarter. So they're up to, let's see here, how many fouls for the game for the Hurricanes. They're up to 15 now, and really struggling to play. Whenever you get in foul trouble that early in the quarter, it's hard to play your game, so you need to settle things down and let the game come to them a little bit.
Owusu, that's his best drive of the contest. And Sheridan, they need a little bit more out of 33 here. Norden in the paint. Adams. Tough shot. Put back, no good. Owusu with the rebound. And here comes Perriana. He'll slow it down. Owusu gets it back again. Jolie. Oh, nice play there by Hibbert. Back down his man and sinks the bucket. So now, I would think for the first time in this game, Sheridan has the lead. Inside a turnover. And that gets Coach Whitty off his seat as he looks a little concerned. Jolie hitting the tray. Now a 52-48 lead for the Bruins. Oh, another turnover. So things coming off the hinges a little bit here for Holland College. Jolie takes it down the lane, goes off the window. So now Sheridan, they're starting to feel it.
Kind of the opposite of what we saw in the first half there for the Hurricanes, as it's been all Bruins to start the third. Mentioned the Hurricanes getting in some foul trouble with the early three in the first minute and a half and capitalizing, knowing that they're going to have to play on their heels a little bit here. Sheridan has been absolutely lights out. Jolie coming on, shaking off a tough first half for a couple of threes. He's now up to 8 points. Perriana has 12. And Nick Campbell, the point guard, with 10 of his own.
So both teams talk things over. Nick Davis has to be happy with the start that he sees from his team. They got their first lead of the contest here in this third quarter.
If you're the Hurricanes right now. Obviously, we can't hear exactly what's going on in that huddle. That's why we have our man Ryan over there to eavesdrop on the conversation. But if you're head coach Josh Whitty, you got to tell your guys just to relax. He mentioned about how they were trying to win every quarter. They certainly haven't been winning this quarter, and they didn't win the last one either. Can't get too high or too low. There's still tons of time left in this game. They just need to take a break, try to get back the momentum, let the game come to them, hit their shots. We know just how good they are. But outside of Burdine and Adams, who have accounted for 28 points, the next highest scorer on Holland is Kai, who has 5, and Roosevelt Wiley has 5. Haven't seen a whole lot from him, so if you can get a couple of those guys going, it could be a different story.
Jumper too strong. Norden will try his luck. That's short. And boy, oh boy, Sheridan, they're strong on the boards. And now Williams has it. And Williams turns it over. Here's Adams. Adams gets fouled. And that foul will go against Paul Williams. As Williams turned the ball over and takes the foul there. That's his third. Adams to take his second shot here. And he gets that one. 54-49 for Sheridan. Under 6 minutes now in this third quarter. Oh, nice turnaround shot there. As that was Hibbert. Norden, inside pass, Adams. Oh, that rolls out. Bounce is going the way of Sheridan. Inside Hibbert. He'll try it again off the glass. Hibbert is on fire. And this is an example of the depth of this Sheridan team.
And these bigs for Holland College normally anchoring the team on defense, but that hasn't been the case here in the third quarter as Sheridan is starting to score a lot of their points from the paint. And there's a badly needed basket from Holland.
And that was Bowden. He drained that one. Wilsu, Williams, he'll try the jumper. Missed that one. That was well off. Norden, Bowden, and he lays that one in. So Holland College trying to get back on track here. Down by 5, 4:35 remaining in this third quarter. Mariana. Jumper, he follows up on it. Good second effort there by Perriana. Let's go down to Ryan.
Hey, guys. I was able to listen into the Hurricanes last time out. Josh Whitley told his players to slow down their offense. He said, slow it down, take what's there. He's looking for a more settled offense. Let's see if his players can listen to him, guys. Back up to you in the booth.
Thanks, Ryan. Jolie with a bucket. Zerosu, Jolie, oh, missed that one, air ball there. So now, Holland College, they'll change things up. Adams and Norden will sit down.
Saw Choli with the big miss there, and he's either been red hot or ice cold as he's 2 of 8 from downtown, taking the most three-pointers for the Bruins. He does have 10 points, though. Carriana continues to anchor this team in every aspect. Owusu trying to work his way up the score sheet.
And a foul coming up here. So Duell gets called for the foul. And he's got some perspiration down on the floor. That gets wiped up. Nick Davis barking out some orders there from the Sheridan bench. Oh, nice put back. So it's now 62-55 in favor of Sheridan.
That's the man right there. That's a real difference maker for the Hurricanes. Roosevelt, the man that they call Chicken Wiley. They need to keep feeding him in the paint so he can use all that 6'6 frame.
Yeah. Swing it around. Rebound picked up there by Bowden. Another shot. Oh, nice putback. That's Joseph. Williams. Olosu. And now Holland College will push it up the court. Nice pass. And the Hurricanes will go to the foul line. That's Joseph.
This is where Holland needs to be. Haven't seen them much at the stripe in this game. Just 5 of 8 prior to these free throws coming up right here. It's going to be Joseph taking these shots. Native of Nassau, Bahamas, in his first year of play in the CCAA.
Gets the roll on that shot. And that one bounces out. There's Cholee, he's back in the game. He gets stripped of the ball. Good hustle there by Joseph. Inside. Oh, that's Chicken Wiley. So now it's a 2-point Sheridan lead. So a foul there against. Yeah.
What a game we have on our hands now. In Charlottetown, both these teams giving it everything that they can to advance to that gold medal game. And the winner of this game will go on to face the Nomads de Montmorency, who beat VIU right before this one. That will be played here tomorrow night at 8 p.m. Atlantic time. And whoever wins this one, that's going to be a fantastic matchup. We'll have it for you on Bell 5 TV 1.
Oh, big time shot. A nice shot by Joseph. Joseph has been heating up here in this third quarter. So Holland College now with a 1-point lead. Bowden went skyward to get that rebound. Going for three, no good. Dolly from way downtown. Oh, big time shot there by Perry Anna.
If you want to be a good shooter, you have to have confidence. And I think it's safe to say that Dylan Perry Anna has that in spades right there. That was from way deep. And he stepped up and knocked it down just like it was a little jumper.
That three ball is way short. And that's going to be Holland College ball. ...65-63 for Sheridan. 34.2 seconds remaining in this third quarter. Here's a drive. And a foul. I think it's going to go against... Yeah, number 12, that'll be Hibbert. Nate Jock is going to come back in the game for the Hurricanes, and now shooting two will be Bowden. That second one. And now Perriana calling a play here. Perriana. Jolie spots up. Left it short. And turned over by Sheridan. Back the other way. Oh! Holy mother. What a jam there by Chicken Wiley. And that's got this gym all fired up. Holy. That's a one-handed jam right there. He went airborne and just threw that one down hard.
Well, in the words of former Toronto Raptors play-by-play man Chuck Swirsky, that was sick, wicked, and nasty right there, flying in and jamming it home. Holland takes the lead. How big is that dunk here?
So there you have it. Sheridan, they came out very strong in this third quarter, but Holland College, they ended the quarter on a high note. Pardon the pun, thanks to Chicken Wiley. Okay, we're going to take a break. It is 66-65 as you take a look at that beautiful jam there by Chicken Wiley. Back to Charlottetown in just a second.
Oh, sorry.
Sorry.
Sorry. Sorry.
Sorry.
Sorry.
Sorry.
Sorry.
Sorry.
Sorry.
Hands on an exciting future, a job you can be proud of, and a life you'll love. It starts with the hands-on education you'll get at Holland College. Go to hollandcollege.com today. Holland College, you'll make it here.
Welcome back to Holland College, everybody. Peter Ruckgazer, Ryan McCachran, and Stephen Campbell. And we're going to have a great finish to this contest here. As it's Holland College, they're up by one over Sheridan, 66-65. And we just saw a beautiful athletic jam there by Chicken Wiley to give the Hurricanes this one-point lead.
Both of these teams won their own conferences, and they're looking like they have all the confidence in the world right now, shaping up for what should be the best quarter of the tournament so far. Sheridan Bruins haven't lost all year, which is absolutely crazy considering some of the competition that they would have went up against there in Ontario. and facing a very good Hurricanes team now with the entire building behind them. It should be a quarter for the ages here.
So underway, fourth quarter action. Inside, oh, that's Chicken Wiley again saying get out of here with that weak stuff. Big time rejection. Oh, and a foul there to Hibbert, and he's in disagreement. So Hibbert with four, he has to sit down, and now Paul Williams will check back in for the Bruins.
Wiley was the guy that we said at halftime needed to step up. Didn't see a whole lot from him in the first two quarters, and we sure have now, as he's made his presence felt in a big way. But another key aspect is Holland's ability to get back to the line, as Sheridan was doing it with ease there at the end of the second quarter, and Holland able to balance it out more now. Very key points from free throws in the fourth quarter in any game, especially one as tight as this.
Yeah. Sorry, there's Steven. He makes the second of two. So we got a tight one on our hands. 67-65. Favor of Holland College. Jolie, he wants a three. Not going to get it. Loose ball. And it comes out here. Perriana, he can't find the bucket. Bowden swings it across. Okay, yeah. With a air ball there. College, a little bit of a trap there. Williams, Mariana, and good hustle there by Owusu. Off the window, put back by Williams. 67 apiece now. Oh, nice move. That was Majok, and he gets fouled.
Fouls on number 17 on Steph Trolley, his first and the team's second. On the line, shooting two for your Hurricanes, it is number
Let's flip it over to Twitter here while we have a moment in the early stages of the fourth quarter. Brianna says, we aren't going to give up without a fight. Demetrius Ferguson says, huge shout out to the Hurricanes from Halifax, former Hurricane alumni. Bryce Maker says, let's go Bruins, number one in the nation. All day again, chiming in saying, down one, time to have some fun, Bruins gang. And Jessica McDonald says, can't stop, won't stop. Oh, stop, let's go Bruins. And thanks everyone for reaching out. And sorry if I missed anyone there. It's getting caught up in the action here and ignoring social media, but there's still time at S. Campbell TV 1 to chime in before this game is over. And Peter, this is shaping up to be an epic finish.
2-point lead here for Sheridan. Baseline shot. And Williams in there, got a hand on it. Back the other way is Joseph. Up, that was the alley-oop as Wiley tried to set up Joseph. Perriana fakes the shot, drives. No good, the pace is picked up here. Here comes Majok. Off the window by Bowden. Tied at 70.
And sometimes the assists are more impressive than the points, even though they don't always seem that way. Chitty Majok with the steal there. going end-to-end, finding his teammate right underneath the rim for the high percentage shot.
Nice pass there by Williams as he got it there for Owosu. These two teams going back and forth. Bowden wide open. ...72 apiece. Mariana kicks it out. Jolie hits the iron. There's Williams with the rebound. He gets it swatted out of his hands. Jolie again. No good. And going skyward there. Joseph on the rebound. Oh, nice jumper by Kayaya. Inside for Williams. Kick it out, Periana. Oh, nothing but net on that one. Knocking down the tray ball. So that's a foul against Holland College.
Yeah, that could be a big foul there. And nice job from the Sheridan defender to step in there and take the charge. So going back the other way. Back and forth, seesaw battle. We expected it to come down to the wire, and that's what we're getting now. The Bruins with the lead. And for Sheridan leading the way, once again is the guard, Periana, 7 of 20 shooting for 23 points, 6 three-pointers. He has been absolutely on fire from downtown.
Oh, is that a three ball? Yes, it is it? So that was the old 78-74 in favor of Sheridan. Now a foul against the Bruins. So only the third team foul. Oh, nice play. Can they get it to go? And no, they can't. They had a couple of opportunities. Off that nice feed by Wiley. Periana. So that's a foul on 11 for Dine. Wilson, no good. Loose ball picked up by Perdine. Now Norden moves it up the court. Inside pass. And Wiley is fouled.
And a huge rebound by Trinity Burdine there on the other end, securing it. It was a tight battle. He was able to do so. And now we're going to get Wiley back onto the line. He's only been there once so far today, but he did make that free throw. And some big ones coming up right here for the Hurricanes as they trail by four. We're getting into the very late stages of this game now. And you can feel the crowd still energized, still excited. A lot more tension now, though, as this isn't the same Sheridan team that we saw in the first couple minutes of that first quarter.
Yeah, that first quarter saw the Sheridan team all discombobulated. Which, for a team that's been unbeaten all season long, was kind of a shock. But the good teams, they figure it out. They find a way. And Sheridan has. And Holland College going punch for punch here against Sheridan. Air ball there from Periana. Pushed up, Bowden. That hits the iron. Now Sheridan will push it up the court. Oh, nice athletic move right there by Nick Campbell. 80-76, Sheridan. And now, Holland College losing their range a little bit. Here's Perriana, fakes it. Looks for his options, spins away there from Bowden. He'll try the jumper. Bowden comes down with a rebound.
Big possession here for Holland.
And gonna call a travel against Chicken Wiley. So 3:20 remaining in regulation. And Holland College will talk things over here with 3:20 remaining. Wow, we've seen a lot of basketball today, but this has been an outstanding contest between Holland College and Sheridan.
It has been, for sure. You don't want to nitpick too much because obviously two very good teams getting this late into the game. But in the first quarter, it seemed that the three-point shot wasn't going to be there for the Hurricanes, and it hasn't been. It's eluded them. They're still shooting 16% from beyond the arc, 5 of 30, and that's not going to cut it against this very good Bruins team. If Holland hasn't been rebounding so well, they've got 53 total rebounds, this one wouldn't be as close as it is now. So I don't imagine that the Hurricanes are going to try any more threes, as at least I would assume Josh Woody would be telling his guys to abandon that strategy right now in the huddle, as I think we're going to see them feed their two biggest guns in Burdine and Chicken Wiley whenever they need it the most. And in crunch time situations like this, you got to go to the guys that got you here, and that's certainly two of Holland's best players, and they have been all season long. And whether you do or die, you have to feed them because they have the hot hand, and they are the leaders of the team.
So you want to see Holland College just get in the paint a little bit more, do you?
Well, I think that's their best strength, that's for sure. They've been doing it all year long. They've got some of the best bigs in the league, like we just mentioned, Burdine and Wiley. Get in the paint, try to just take it right to the rim, and they've been doing a better job at getting to the line now in the second half as it's progressed. So I think you need to keep trying that strategy here because the three-point shot simply isn't working, Pete.
The big man Adams is back in there. Loose ball. And now moved ahead by Norton. And then he turns it over. Ill-advised play there by Norton. Let's see if Holland College is going to pay for it. Olosu hitting a three. Yeah, they paid for it. Turn the ball over in an inopportune time, and it's now 83-76 in favor of Sheridan. Norton tries three, and there you go, like you said. That's not going to work for them. And, wow, 83-76, 2:26 remaining in regulation.
Well, in terms of your best players getting the job done, you saw Owosu right there. Hasn't had the best night. Only hit 1-3 before that. Stepped up, made the huge shot to give himself some breathing room between the Bruins and the Canes. Holland trying to answer right back. Wasn't there, so a little bit of a hole now, but still some time to come back. 2 minutes and 23 seconds. And can cut the tension in this gym right now with a knife.
Two big free throws here for Dine. It's the first of two. Makes both of them. 83-78. 2:20 left. Jolie, little teardrop, gets it to go. Adams, he's gonna drive. And he sinks that. Sheridan by five here. Under 2 minutes. Inside. They kick it out. Owosu. No good. And Chicken Wiley has that rebound. Norden. And that's going to be a foul call against Sheridan. So again, two big free throws for the Canes. Okay, let's send it over to Ryan. Ryan, what do you got for us?
It's another Hurricane coaches Josh Willey's last discussion with his team during their timeout, and he told them they have to up their physicality. He said, get position, get control, and get the rebound. He's trying to will his team back into the game. Let's see if he can do it, guys.
Thanks a lot, Ryan. Just what you said, Steven. That got to get that ball, get it down into the low post, get it in the paint, and do their magic.
Even yesterday, they dropped 113 points on Sates, and I believe they only had 3 three-pointers. So their proof that you don't have to hit the three-point shot to succeed is there's a big miss.
Sheridan by 4. Mariana. He'll take his time. Owosu back to Mariana. 2 on the shot clock. Throws one up. And that's going to be Holland College ball. So 108 now remaining. Norden. Wiley. And that ball picked off. And the lay-in there by Owosu. And that was a costly mistake. And another turnover. And that could have been the dagger right there for Sheridan. As it looks like they're going to seal the deal here. Still 39 seconds though remaining. And now for Dine had to foul his man. And so 2 turnovers there really cost Holland College.
That's tough right there. 2 back-to-back turnovers as the air has just completely been sucked out of this room now. And for the Hurricanes in these pressure situations, little mental mistakes like that one right there. Unfortunately, those have a habit of creeping up on the biggest stages like we just saw right now. And Hurricanes gonna have a very tough time mounting a comeback now. And the Sheridan Bruins haven't lost a game all year. And they're proving why right here. Huge plays on defense creating those steals by especially Owosu, their all-Canadian player.
And another turnover. And Mariana was fouled. So 6-point lead for Sheridan. And boy, I don't know any other way to say it, but Sheridan was just simply awful. They were awful in the first quarter of this game. I hadn't seen this team play, but I heard the reputation and the fact they were undefeated, and I said to myself, this can't be the same team that I've been reading about leading into this tournament. Well, they showed me how good they are as they really got things together in the second quarter. And since that time, they've really played some great ball, and they're 28.9 seconds away from heading to the final.
They certainly have. Yeah, that's right. I mean, give full marks to Sheridan. They went up against a powerhouse team here in their own gym, hosting nationals, the crowd entirely on their side, and they came to play for the Hurricanes. I mean, I'm not really sure what else there is to say. They made it to the semis last year, lost a heartbreaker to Humber, 2 points away from reaching the final. They felt like they had the team to get back there. They're hosting the Nationals. It's going to be a tough one if Holland isn't able to pull off the comeback here. But they have nothing to be ashamed of. So going up against the number one seed, best team in the country.
Yeah, not at all. Holland College, they acquitted themselves very well in this game. And on the first day of the tournament, they did a great job they still got a chance at a bronze medal. And there's nothing to be ashamed of walking away with a medal at a national championship.
That's right. Yep, they did claim bronze last year. Still an impressive feat. Small school from Charlottetown, smallest province in Canada. They are a big athletic program and a force to be reckoned with in pretty much every sport, year in and year out, especially the basketball team. The way that Whitty is able to recruit, you look at a lot of the names in this roster as far as the Bahamas, places like that, and the Hurricanes, I assume that we'll see both of these teams back here in the Nationals next year.
Yeah, they put a lot of resources in their sports programs here at Holland College, and it's paid off. And like you said, this is a small school. This is not a big school from Southern Ontario.
2,500 people.
Yeah. Not a big school like some of the schools from Southern Ontario. So, and they've done a great job recruiting in the Bahamas, getting some real good athletes from that country to come up here in both football and basketball. And now Williams goes back to the free throw line. Nine-point lead here with 28 seconds remaining. And make that a 10-point lead. And Norden, he stepped out. So, the late stages of this one, Holland College, they put it in the spanner. Here's Perriana, he's had a very strong game here at point guard for Sheridan. Easy bucket. Norden will try three, no good. And they'll run the clock out. And the Sheridan Bruins got off to a real terrible start. And they come back here and they win this one, 93-81. What a great display of basketball though, Stephen, in this game.
That's right, and what a great final we're gonna have here tomorrow at 8 o'clock Atlantic time on 5TV1. It's gonna be the Sheridan Bruins, still yet to lose since the opening game of the campaign, facing off against the RSEQ champions, Montmorency Nomads. Really looking forward to that one. And again, just looking at the stat sheet in front of me here, there's nothing really that stands out in terms of differences except for three-pointers. Sheridan was able to hit the three, Holland College wasn't. Sheridan hit 12, they shot 32% from there, and Holland hit only 5, they shot 15%, and that was the difference maker in this game.
So we're going to await the players of the game here, and we got a full slate of games tomorrow.
And the player of the game from your Holland College Hurricanes, number 14, Chase Bowden.
So, Chase Bowden, player of the game for Holland College.
Number 7, Dylan Perriana.
And no surprise there, as Perriana was just so solid at the point guard position for Sheridan.
26 points for Perriana, 7 of 23 shooting, and Bowden for Holland there. He had 11 points of his own, but the biggest difference was 14 rebounds, an absolute beast in the paint once again.
So, Ryan McCaffrey, waiting to talk to Perriana, who was just a little general out there at the point guard position. And Sheridan, they'll be into the final tomorrow. And let's now send it over to Ryan McCaffrey. He's with Mr. Perriana. Ryan?
I'm down here with the Sheridan player of the game. 26 points, 4 assists, 5 steals. How do you feel about your game today?
I just did what I had to do to get the job done. I'm not really worried about my numbers, but the guys needed me to score some more points today, so that's what I did, and we won.
How'd you feel about beating Holland College in their own gym during their own tournament?
We knew we were going to get the home crowd. Kind of excited today. They knew they were going against the number one team in the nation, and we told the guys to keep their composure and go out there and do what we do, and we came out with the W.
How will it feel to possibly hang a medal around your neck at the end of this tournament?
That's what this is all for. That's why we booked the flight to come to PEI. That's why we won our Ontario Championship. That's why we practiced all season, and now we're here.
Great, thanks.
Thank you.
Back up to you guys.
Thank you very much, Ryan. So there you see the final score. Sheridan, they win this one 93-81. They're heading to the final tomorrow. So on behalf of Ryan McCachran, Stephen Campbell, and our entire 5TV1 crew, I'm Peter Ruckgazer saying so long from Charlottetown. We'll see you tomorrow. It is Championship Saturday right here on 5TV1.